Always try to make sure, like, my friends that didn't choose the streets, the ones that we consider to be squares, like, I always try to make sure I tell them how proud of them I am. Because they the strong ones. They the tough guys. They the ones who didn't break. Most of us broke early in life, man. We fell to the pressure. We fell to the temptation. And they came outside the same hood and walked past the same temptation, all the shit that's going on, the peer pressure, and they stayed focused. They stayed focused. They ain't let that shit break them. All the girls calling them lames, not wanting to give them no pussy because they considered to be a square and corny and all that shit, and they still stayed on course. They didn't break.
Shalom, this is the brother that's out of Moth back at you with another lesson. And I pray this lesson is edifying to the lambs and to the sheep of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahawashai, Bahashem, Rukahakwadash. And double honor to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone who do it well. Peace and salutation to the Bayah Shah Dawada, which is the house of David. Now, after hearing this man speak on the issue that he went into, I can't help but thinking about the book of Proverbs, the first chapter, that wisdom cries out into the streets. But do our people hear the cries? Do they hear the sighing and crying for the abominations of Babylon the Great? What we've been crying out, do they really hear it? No, they don't. They hear the song of an hopeless end. They hear an insatiable desire of genocide by being locked down in prison systems or falling into the grave. And he's right, we resent the street life. On a daily basis, we try our best to resist the temptations that Jake falls into. Okay, most of the time, by being intoxicated. Okay, drunk off the paradox of this place, Babylon the Great. Because what it does, it pours out a concoction of foul men, of foolish women mixed in with sin. Okay, inequity, lasciviousness. The scriptures say where equity cannot enter. All right, that's Isaiah 59 and 14. This is Isaiah 59:14, and judgment is turned away backwards, and justice standeth afar off. For the truth is fallen in the street, and equity cannot enter. Yeah, truth has fallen into the streets, into the barrios, into the ghettos, into the suburbs of Babylon the Great. But only the elect are the ones that can see it. Okay? That can take hold of it, that can make it a part of your daily sacrifice. Because the spirit is willing, but the flesh is always weak. All right? And when it's weak, temptation can creep in. So what he was saying was true. Yeah, some brothers do fall by temptations. Some brothers do gotta, you know, sacrifice certain things. You may have a child, and you may have to stop what you're doing to take care of your child. You know, and you don't have an education. So now you gotta do what you gotta do. How many times have we heard that? I just gotta do what I gotta do. But no one ever goes to the Heavenly Father and prays first. No one just gives it up to the Heavenly Father and let Him work it out, right? You seek your own ways, and that way leads to destruction. And you ain't gonna win every battle, but the word says, blessed is the man that endures. All right, endures what? The calls of the streets. So we're trying our best to walk by faith and not by sight. We've chosen the finer things of heaven, the things we cannot see, the treasures that store for us, rather than the finer things of this life. See, Jake doesn't have patience. He wants it now. And that's a trait of Esau. Cain, he couldn't wait for it. Esau couldn't wait. He had to eat. And our people have assimilated into the ways of Greeks, the modern day Romans, these Americans, right? This is James 1 and 12. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him, right? The Lord has promised those that love him that we will receive a crown of life. And the brother in the intro said, verbatim, he fell to the pressure and the temptations. That's what he said. He also said, that there were brothers that had the same temptations, but they walked right past it. You see, right? Because the Lord had a plan for them. The Lord has a plan for us. Every person is in their lot right now. Every person is where they're supposed to be. And again, I want to reiterate that we ain't going to win every battle. But the Lord has taken you out of that darkness to show you his marvelous light. And see, now brothers like this, the life that they was living and the life they was glorifying, now they're a bit envious of the so-called square brother. All right, the brother who has his shit together, the brother that's not hanging out in the streets. This is the man that's about his business, and his business is the Father's business. That's how we're viewed as squares. We don't do drugs. We don't drink excessively. We don't commit adultery. You know, our lifestyle is pretty simple. When Jake says they get into the money, that means they get into the bag. But when you say that to a brother like us, you know, getting to the money, that means getting into the scriptures. Because this is where the money is at. This is where we're going to get paid at. This is where you get everlasting life at. Can't no man on the street pay you a wage that's better than that. Okay? All right? So Jake, his objective is how he can obtain, all right, federal notes. You don't think that we know brothers from back in the day that's still doing it, that still got it? Brothers with bankrolls, they got women, they live a life of allure. Okay? Opulence. But understand, a fast life leads to a fast death. This is Sirach 9 and 11. Envy not the glory of a sinner, for thou knowest not what shall be his end. All right? A man of the Lord is set apart and is delivered from their past deeds. When we was in the world, we would watch Cash Money Millionaires. You know, Lil Wayne and them bling blinging. We wanted that life. But now we despise that life. Now that we've seen the glory of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, which is why brothers aren't interested in that baller life. Because the glory of a sinner's end game is grim. You know, most of the time you end up in jail, you end up with a disease, or you get popped. That's pretty much how it goes, right? Let's get a precept in the book of Proverbs 23. This is Proverbs 23 and 17. Let not thine heart envy sinners, but be thou in the fear of the Lord all day long. Yeah, we fear the Lord all day long. We don't envy sinners because we know what the end may be. So how you gonna answer to the angels and Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai when you had the truth right in front of you? We read that wisdom crieth in the streets, but your ears are plugged, which is why some brothers have went down certain avenues, and that avenue led to something that may correct you. Right? Doing time. Getting women pregnant that you don't want to spend your life with, and now you got 4 or 5 baby mamas. Proverbs 23 and 18, for surely there is an end, and thine expectations shall not be cut off. Right, for surely there's an end. That's a fact. The end is coming. So what manner of persons should we be in? We should be meditating in the scriptures. We should be exhorting with all holy conversation and godliness. And when you begin to grow into this thing, you're going to begin to grow apart from cantankerous people who you used to know. Your circle is going to get smaller, and your body and your mind is going to grow. And when you depart from some of these people, you know, hey, you make yourself a prey. Let's get Isaiah 59 and 15. All right, it says, truth faileth, and he that departeth from evil make himself a prey. And the Lord saw it, and it displeased him. And there's no judgment in the streets where Jake lives at. That's righteous, man. It's all in unrighteousness. You know, that Clone Tyrone movie was on point, right? But a remnant ain't gonna follow the ways that Esau set up to have you go astray, right? When we wanna get out of a situation that's unfruitful or away from a person, you try to battle demons sometimes, but you lose within. You may pray and ask Yahweh Bashim Havashai to remove enemies out of your life. Okay, and next thing you know, you start losing friends because he's working in the background for you. Okay? Jake chose the lifestyle of money, cars, clothes, and hoes. And you may have been a part of that at one time, but a miracle happened on your behalf. Because while you was, okay, walking with the ungodly, he raised you out of that. He cleansed your mind and gave you a new spirit. Okay, you became new. Well, Jake, in his maturity now, he recognizes that what the Lord has done for us is much more significant than what they got going on in the streets. All right, this is Psalms 1:1. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. That's right, we're ordered not to stand with sinners. And that may be hard to dodge sometimes, you know, due to your environment. You may have a small space where you live at. You may have people around you at all times that don't care about the Most High. Well, worry about your own salvation. Okay, we're on a different mission than most. We didn't get into this word to chase. Jake is in the streets chasing, and this is what this brother is talking about. He wishes he could have went that route. Being a square, a man going about his business, instead of being the cool brother that got all the women, got all the fur coats, that got the cars and got all that stuff. And now later on in your life, you got nothing because you didn't spend 10, 15 years in Esau's prison system. We didn't get into this thing to chase. Okay, chase women, chase subscribers, self-glorification. No brother I know wants to be a Hebrew rap artist. Okay, our peace, our joy is to serve the Lord and teach sound doctrine. And that's it. The book of Titus, the first chapter, the 8th verse reads, but a lover of hospitality, a lover of good men, sober, just, holy, temperate, holding fast the faithful word as he had been taught. Yeah, the faithful word, that he may be able by sound doctrine both to exhort and convince the gainsayers. You see, and having all these qualities makes the body function spiritually fluid, teaching sound doctrine. Okay? And it's not the smooth things that Jake and Eve want to hear. No, we speak scripturally. So the brother was right. Women don't look at us now as the hot brother on the block. You know, people scoff. They laugh at our garments. But this is part of our chastisement. We get a reward for this. Okay? And that's all going to change when Isaiah 4 kicks in anyway. Okay? This is 1 Corinthians 4:9. For I think that Yahweh Bashim Havashai has set forth us the apostles last, has set forth us the apostles last, as it were appointed to death. For we are made a spectacle unto the world and to the angels and to men. Yeah, we're made a laughing stock, a spectacle, an outcast amongst our family, okay, our ex-friends. But like the brother said, they stayed on course. We're staying on the course by enduring, by using discernment of the times and setting our hearts for mourning, which really is wisdom. Okay? All right, let's get Ecclesiastes 7:4. The heart of the wise is in the house of mourning, but the heart of fools is in the house of mirth. And that's pretty simple right there. The heart of the wise is mourning. We're crying and sighing. We're telling you about the enemy that's coming. But Jake just wants to party. Jake and Eve, they just want to get it how they live. At what point do you become tired of the struggle in the flesh and never giving your spirit an opportunity to grow in you? We always hear Jake and Eve say, let go and let God. Well, when are you going to see that your way ain't working? Right? The scriptures say, lead not to your own understanding. There's only one way. And that's the way of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai. And that's the question that's already been answered in the heavens. And we see it every day. The Lord has blinded them until he has mercy on them. They're not going to be able to see. They ain't going to be able to hear. And they're going to keep going through that wide gate. So like their brother said, the real tough guys are the men of the Lord who've turned away from darkness. And you've continued in the faith, dwelling now in the tabernacle of light. All right? So with that, I give all honor and glory to Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim Rakahakwadash, and double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone who do well. This is the brother Azaha Amah, Wa Ababa Ba, Shalom.